we are looking at bearing. Now, one thing we have to know, what is exactly bearing? Okay, bearing actually is direction. Now, remember, before we looked at direction using the cardinal points, but now, under bearing, we look at direction using an angle. An angle alone will show us direction. How is this angle supposed to be? It has rules. One, it has to be in 3 digits, e.g. 030, 140, 330, etc. However, this angle, in case there are decimals, we have to keep only one decimal. For example, 060.5 degrees, 170.8 degrees, 211.2 degrees. Now, this angle must be 3 degrees. If this angle has decimal, then we have to keep one decimal place. How is this angle measured so that we can know bearing? One, must start from north. Two, while measuring this angle, you must move clockwise. Example, bearing of A from B is 040 degrees. Now, when you read this example properly, A from B, the word from tells us that we are going to be starting at B in order to see A. Now let's position our B. That's our B. We said we must have a north. Now, we have to put our north like that, and this is our north. Remember, if I put this small line, this angle here is 90. My estimation of 40 will end up around somewhere there. So we shall say the bearing is moving clockwise 40 degrees in order to see the position of A. So clearly, once you start from north and you move clockwise to represent that given angle, then you will be able to understand direction using bearing. Another example, bearing of T from Q is 200. The word from clearly tells us that we have to be positioned at Q. Let's say my Q is there. Now, before we do anything, we have to keep our north. And after keeping our north, we have to estimate the 90s, and everybody can see here till here is a 90, another 90, another 90, and another 90. If I want the bearing to be 200, that means from my north, I will move clockwise, I will pass 90, I will pass 180, just after passing 180, I have to stop. Why? Because that region will be representing our 200 degrees. So, I will be able to see position T. This is the introduction to bearing. And now, we have seen the example on how bearing behaves. We look again. We know bearing is direction. This bearing is measured using an angle. This angle must be 3 digits. And in case this angle has got decimals, we must keep only one decimal place. How do you measure this angle? We start from the north, and we must always move on a clockwise direction. We saw our first example and our second example. Now, in order for us to solve questions in bearing, we need to know some other path that can help us. One, we need to know about alternate angles. Other students call them Z angles. Alternate angles, they come from parallel lines. Parallel lines, alternate angles state that the angle there is always equal to the angle here. Now, basing on that rule, we can have example bearing, e.g. the bearing of A from B is 0, 60 degrees. Find the bearing of B from A. Now, first we can tell, starting from B to see A, this is our bearing. This position is B, this is our north, 60 degrees could be somewhere here by virtue of estimate, and somewhere where we are not given the distance could be the position of A. So this is our first line. But when we are told to find the bearing of B starting from A, that means now I have to stand at A, put my north at A, then move clockwise until you make the line of sight where you can view B. Now the question is, how much is this angle that you have moved and hence that you are bearing? Using the alternate theory that this one and this one are equal, it will clearly tell us that if this part here is 60, then also this part here will be 60. But remember, when you start from north till down here, you have covered 180 degrees. This means you will move 180 degrees and you will add on another 60, giving us as our final bearing. Hence, the bearing of B from A will be 240. Now, to get this 240, we use the knowledge of alternate angle theories. Two, we need to know the trigonometry ratios. Usually, when we are dealing with 3 points, and if those 3 points form a right angle, then this can help us to solve. Let's say we have position A, position B, and position C. Maybe we are told this is 8 centimeters, and perhaps this is 6 centimeters. And we are told, find bearing of C from A. Now, in order for me to find the bearing of C when I'm starting at A, it means from my north, I need to know this angle. But how will I know this angle? One, I know that the whole complete till here is 180. But if I know this part here, which I don't know, this part theta, I will take it away from 180. Hence, I will get the value there. How will I know this angle is by using the trigonometric ratios. Now, this is opposite and this is hypotenuse. Opposite and hypotenuse is given by sine. Sine theta will be equal to opposite over 8. To get the theta angle itself, I will have to do the sine inverse of 6 over 8. Once I get the sine inverse of 6 over 8, I will be able to subtract it there. Using our calculator, we can get sine of this. So once I get this sine, I can subtract it. Now these are the natures under which we can use to find the bearing. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the discussion, you can like and subscribe to my channel.